Falcon Heavy is the most powerful rocket in the world by a factor of two, with the ability to lift into orbit nearly 64 metric tons, or approximately 141,000 pounds. It can lift more than twice the payload of the next closest operational vehicle, the Delta IV Heavy. Falcon Heavy is composed of three Falcon 9 engine cores, whose 27 Merlin engines together generate more than 5 million pounds of thrust at liftoff, equal to approximately 18 747 aircraft. On February 7, 2018, Falcon Heavy made its first launch into orbit, successfully landing two of its three boosters and launching its payload to space. Curious to know more about the Falcon Heavy spacecraft configuration and objectives? Keep watching. Cost effectiveness. The Falcon Heavy is SpaceX's entry into the heavy lift launch vehicle market. As the name suggests, the Heavy is a larger vehicle than the Falcon 9, comprising a Falcon 9 with two more Falcon 9 stages strapped on either side. Each of the strapped-on rockets has nine engines, which work together as boosters to lift a heavy payload. SpaceX predicted that the Falcon Heavy would launch twice the payload of the shuttle at about 1/15th of the cost of a shuttle launch, which equates to an approximately 97% reduction in launch costs compared with the shuttle. How could SpaceX reduce launch costs by such a margin? Before answering that question, it's worth clearing up how launch prices are determined. When it comes to calculating the costs of government launches, the actual taxpayer costs can only be guessed at by calculating from the cost plus contract costs, which are usually for multiple launches from the same customer. Now, if SpaceX has multiple launches on its books, the posted price will obviously be reduced according to the number of launches. More launches equals lower costs. At the time of the Intelsat contract, for example, SpaceX had a launch manifest of over 40 payloads divided between Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy. This number far exceeded any current government contracts, and SpaceX was adding more flights every month. Another factor determining cost is rocket performance. The only rocket in service comparable to the Falcon Heavy is the Delta IV Heavy. While a Falcon Heavy looks similar to a Delta IV Heavy, its performance is much higher, which means its cost per launch is much lower. A Falcon Heavy can put 53 metric tons in orbit compared to the Delta IV Heavy's 23 metric tons, a 230% improvement. More importantly, from a customer perspective, a Falcon Heavy cost only about $100 million per launch, whereas the Delta IV Heavy cost $435 million per launch based on an Air Force contract of $1.74 billion for four launches. When it comes to calculating payload costs, the Delta IV Heavy with its 23 metric ton LEO capability costs about $19 million per ton, or about $8,600 per pound, compared to the Falcon Heavy's price of about $850 per pound, or $1.9 million per ton, almost exactly 1/10 of the current Delta IV Heavy price. It's a huge price differential, one that often prompts the inevitable question, how can the Falcon outperform the Delta by such a wide margin? The main reasons can be found in the development and design of the Falcon 9. Number 1. Low manufacturing cost. Number 2. Low operational cost, such that the low man hours needed per launch. Number 3. High efficiency performance in flight. The low manufacturing cost is a result of the Falcon Heavy's design, which uses three nearly identical rocket stages. That is a design strategy that translates into more production of the same units and a reduction in unit cost. For example, SpaceX is building towards producing a Falcon 9 first stage or Falcon Heavy side booster every week and an upper stage every 2 weeks at their plant in Hawthorne, California. At this rate, if this production schedule is achieved, within a few years, SpaceX will be producing more rockets per year than all the rocket companies on the planet combined. The next key factor in reducing payload costs to LEO is high flight efficiency, although not always resulting in successful launches, a goal that SpaceX has achieved in the Falcon 1 and 9 rockets by using a short upper stage, which consists of a single Merlin engine to place the payload into orbit. For the Falcon Heavy, SpaceX has used the possibility of creating a hydrogen-oxygen upper stage, which could boost the Falcon Heavy payload up to 70 tons. In addition to the development of the hydrogen-oxygen upper stage, the Falcon Heavy has benefited from propellant cross-feeding from the side boosters to the center core. During flight, the Falcon Heavy's two outer stages pump part of their propellant into the center stage, which is similar to how the shuttle's external tank fed its main engines. This means these stages exhausted their propellant faster, but it also meant that the center stage had almost a full load of propellant at separation, where it is already at altitude and at speed, which is a method that gave the Falcon Heavy performance comparable to that of a three-stage rocket. Falcon Heavy objectives. So far, we've shown that Falcon Heavy is a powerful and cost-effective spacecraft, but the main question is, what is it used for? The good news for the commercial launch industry is that the Falcon Heavy opened the door to much larger payloads thanks to the vehicle's large payload fairing, a capability that can be exploited by launching more than just one communication satellite in a single payload. The Falcon Heavy is also able to launch heavier payloads, including space station modules such as the centrifuge accommodation module, which was the victim of ISS budget cutting. The Falcon Heavy also plays a role in human missions beyond LEO, perhaps ferrying a long-duration Dragon capsule attached to a crew habitat for an asteroid mission. Beyond the Falcon Heavy, SpaceX is building a Falcon Super Heavy rocket along with SpaceX Starship spacecraft. They represent a fully reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. Starship will be the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever deployed, with the ability to carry in excess of 100 metric tons to Earth orbit. Musk has always indicated that he intends to continue trying to lower launch costs and improve capability, which means it's unlikely that the Falcon Heavy is the last vehicle in the SpaceX family of launchers. In fact, the Falcon Heavy, with its 53 metric tons of payload, can't be considered a true heavy lift vehicle, HLV, since these are generally considered to be ones that can lift 70 metric tons or more. For example, NASA's planned space launch system is an HLV that will lift 70 metric tons in its first version and 130 metric tons in a later version. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Falcon Heavy rocket configuration. Falcon Heavy was launched in its reusable configuration, allowing for a landing approach of both side boosters and the central core. The side boosters consisted of two previously flown Falcon 9 first stages that were reused from the CRS-9 mission in July of 2016 and the TICOM 8 launch in May of 2016. Only the central core was newly built because it needs to support stronger forces during ascent, so that a regular first stage could not be used. The upper stage was the same as on a Falcon 9, being equipped with a nose cone. The side boosters have different aerodynamic properties than the usual Falcon 9 boosters with cylindrical interstage. Therefore, SpaceX equipped them with larger and sturdier grid fins made of titanium in order to guide the atmospheric descent accurately. However, the central core still used conventional aluminum grid fins due to the fact that aerodynamic properties are very similar to those of a conventional Falcon 9 first stage. Moreover, the Roadster was mounted on the second stage using a custom-made payload adapter and was encapsulated in a conventional fairing, which is a structure whose primary function is to produce a smooth outline and reduce drag forces. Falcon Heavy also supports the launch of Dragon capsules without a fairing. Falcon Heavy launch. A Falcon Heavy rocket took off from Kennedy Space Center at Cape Canaveral, Florida, after a delay of over 2 hours due to high winds. The Roadster was successfully placed in its orbit, and its two booster cores returned to land at landing zone 1s and 2 several minutes later. The landing of the central core failed, while its fate was initially ambiguous due to signal loss and heavy smoke. Several hours after the launch, Musk confirmed that the booster had not survived the recovery attempt due to the fact that two of the three engines necessary to land were unable to reignite, The booster hit the water at 500 kilometers per hour and 100 meters away from the drone ship, which caused damage to two of the drone ship's station-keeping thrusters. On the post-flight conference, the central core ran out of the igniter fluid. However, the central core loss did not impact future SpaceX operations. In conclusion, the Falcon Heavy flight mission was intended to accomplish several objectives, such as to launch the Falcon Heavy from the pad through the atmosphere, including Max-Q flight phase, to separate the side booster cores from the continuing first center core and upper stage, to return the two side boosters to Cape Canaveral and land them simultaneously at landing zones 1 and 2, to separate the center core and light the upper stage to orbit insertion, to land the first stage booster core on an autonomous spaceport drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, in the Atlantic Ocean, to relight the upper stage to orbit in the Van Allen belts for several hours to shoe radiation resistance, to relight the upper stage again and put the payload into its heliocentric orbit in order to demonstrate the lifetime for the upper stage that's suitable for orbit insertion, and finally, to recover the payload fairing. Additionally, the sole purpose of including the Roadster on the Falcon Heavy flight was to demonstrate that it can launch payloads as far as the orbit of Mars, and it exceeded its projected route by extending its aphelion to near the asteroid belt beyond Mars. However, it did not test or demonstrate the separation of the second stage and payload. At the end of this video, you may need to know some terminologies, such as the Van Allen radiation belt, which is a zone of energetic charged particles, most of which originate from the solar wind that are captured by and held around the planet by its magnetic field. Earth has two such belts, and sometimes others may be temporarily created. They are named after James Van Allen, who is credited with their discovery. They also extend from an altitude of about 640 to 58,000 kilometers above the surface, in which region radiation levels vary. The heliocentric orbit, which is an orbit around the barycenter of the solar system that is usually located within or very near to the surface of the sun. All planets, comets, and asteroids in the solar system and the sun itself are in such orbits, as are many artificial probes. The moons of planets in the solar system, by contrast, are not heliocentric orbits, as they orbit their prospective planet despite the fact that the moon has a convex orbit around the sun. The barycenter of the solar system is always very near to the sun. However, it moves through space as time passes, depending on where other large bodies in the solar system, such as Jupiter and other large gas planets, are located at that time. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you learn anything new in this video? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.